and do it forever. Amen. We're so grateful to God. One thing I am going to ask, amen, if you can, limit the walking, please. Seems like when the word comes, we got to go everywhere. You know, on the phone and all that. Amen. I'm telling you, we need a word for this season. Amen. Amen. We need a word. Amen. So we're going to get ready to prepare ourselves for the word. But I do want to make mention on the 15th, men that are here, invite somebody out to our men's breakfast. And then you want this man to see you, bring somebody with sheep and get sheep.
Amen.
Go fishing. Amen. Bring some of them brothers that you hung out with. Just tell them to come with you. All you got to say, we want to eat.
Amen.
You say, come on, say, we want breakfast. You'd be surprised. And it's free. I tell anybody, if it's free, it's for me. Coming out to breakfast. That's something you got to say.
Amen.
When they get here, the word will do the rest.
Amen.
Amen.
So we thank God for all that has taken place. We thank God for all of you that make up the congregation this morning. Amen. Are y'all ready to hear a word?
Amen.
Come on, y'all. Come on. Thank God for hearing.
And hearing
by the word of God.
By the word of God.
Without faith,
without faith,
it is impossible.
It is impossible.
Please God.
Please God.
Faith is
taking
God
at His word.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. We thank God. Say this with me. How can we hear?
How can we hear?
Without a preacher.
Without a preacher.
And how can they preach?
And how can they preach?
Except they've been sent.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Y'all believe that?
Amen.
Walk by faith.
Amen.
Amen. We thank you here in the mighty word. We're loving on you. Amen. I'm going to decrease. And we're going to bring Minister Bob to come and bring us the word. Let me tell you something. I know how to hear from God.
Amen.
I know when God tells me to take it easy.
Yes.
Rest your body.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And then also watch this. In the moment of my best, He's letting me observe His house.
Amen.
Sometimes I need to sit back and watch.
Right.
And see what's been going on while I've been praying and studying.
Yes.
So that we can get the help. Because that's it. Jesus says, I'm coming back for a church.
Hey,
church. Hey, this. Y'all in the scripture?
Yes.
I'm coming back for the ecclesia.
Yes.
I'm coming back for a church without a spot. Or and He put us as under-shepherd to watch over the sheep.
Yes,
he says, I'm coming back for a church without a spot or wrinkle.
Amen.
Y'all tell them, young men, I don't know where they're going, but sit down. Y'all watch them. That's just coming through.
Amen.
Amen. It's all right. Yeah. See, that's why I watch.
Amen.
Train the child up in the way they should go.
Yeah.
When they get old, they won't.
Amen.
Amen. So I'm observing, but we thank God has put men and women in our lives,
amen,
that also can share the word of God.
Amen.
We thank God for, I've been observing Him. I've been watching Him. He's been faithful in coming in the word class.
Amen.
Come on, come on. Didn't I say that? Coming in the word class. He's been faithful coming to the word class. He talks to me. He
communicates.
And I feel within my spirit is
alright.
Amen.
Amen.
I told him one thing. We just talked even in the back. I said, don't you let nobody take your anointing.
Yeah,
ain't worth losing for nobody. Y'all hear me? Nobody. Not at the Lala, not you.
Amen.
It ain't worth it. Not for money. Not for fame. Not for fortune. Because we know gifts come without repentance.
Yes, that's right. Amen. I know that's right.
But if you walk in according with God,
yes,
He says your gift will make you.
Yes.
Yes. Amen. Yes. We thank God. Amen. Can we all stand to our feet one more time? He won't stand on you. It brings me great pleasure and privilege to introduce our very own minister, Donald Newsome. Let's receive him with a heartache. Amen. Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Oh, yes,
Lord.
and all that is within. Amen. I just am humbled. It's a great honor to be behind this pulpit, speaking to existence. Pulpit. And I want to thank God, first of all. Many of you, I've had the privilege, and I thank God for Pastor Bernard Brown, my pastor, from his first lady. Amen. I've been having the privilege to preach at the 9:30 service. When I got the call, amen. When I got the call, because a lot of you know that I'm living by faith and courage. And I've been in a transition. You know, sit down. I'm not going to keep you. Your gifts will make room for you. And I'm very humbled to have this opportunity to be in the power pack. And I thank God for Pastor, for his patience with me, and his diligence and his willingness, and for me to accept correction in love.
Amen. Amen.
To accept correction in love. In love. So I honor God for him, as well as my man, Minister Stefan. He's been a blessing to me as well. He's been a true brother. He checks up on me and encourages me. And, you know, the Bible says that it's not good for man to be alone, but he just didn't mean that for marriages. He meant that for the Bible. So it's good to have somebody that can pull on you and to keep you. Believe that. For one, can change 1,000, but two,
for
10,000. So we just honor God. I'm not hoop and holler like Pastor. That's, you know, but I'm definitely going to bring forth the word. We thank God. Amen. We thank God. Amen. I know some of us has been going through some all kinds of difficulties, hardships, trials, and just plain old attacks from hell. And it just seems like you get victory in one area and then attacks in another area. And it feels like you're just in continual warfare. You're just staying in warfare. And you're caught in the spin cycle of like a washing machine, and you're trying to turn it off. But here's the reason why, though. Because the devil wants to wear you out. Oh, man. Peter said it best. He says, consider it not strange of the fiery trials that shall come aside to try you, as if though something strange has happened to you. Oh, man. Jesus said to Peter, he said, I pray that your faith does not fail you, for the devil is out to sift you as wheat. Daniel said, in the book of Daniel, said in chapter 7, it says, he shall speak great words against the Most High, and he shall wear out the saints. Not eight, but saints. So the word of the Lord is revealing to me that God is restoring joy to his heart. Come on, y'all know what you're saying? Joy to his people. And since God said that word, I believe someone needs to hear that. For somebody, this declaration is going to shift you to another season. Lift your hands, please, and declare this. I will hear your word.
I will hear your word.
I will receive your word.
I will receive your word.
And I will believe your word.
And I will believe your word.
See, we got to speak life. You got to speak life, man. You know, declare that this is a day of restitution. This is a day of restoration. You know, restitution means to get it back. Restore means to put it back in its proper place and its proper order. Now, Jesus said, the thief has come to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus also says, I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Does anybody want the abundance? Promise of God. Oh man, let's go to the word, amen. We're gonna go to the book of Job. Chapter 20. Verse 15. You can say, see, you're just gonna go straight. Yeah. We have another service, so definitely go straight in. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And the word of the Lord says, he has swallowed down riches and he shall vomit them up again. God shall cast them out of his belly. He shall suck the poison of ass. The viper's tongue shall slay him. He shall not see the rivers, the floods, the brooks of honey and butter. That which he labored for shall he restore, and shall not swallow it down. According to his substance shall the restitution be. And he shall not rejoice therein. The word of the Lord goes on to say, because he hath oppressed and hath forsaken the poor, because he hath violently, it is, he has violently taken away an house which he buildeth not. Verse 9 says, surely he shall not feel quiet in his belly. He shall not save of that which he desired. Let's go to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37. Very familiar passage. You have to speak faith, speak life. You have to say amen.
Amen.
Read out of King James Version. And it says, the hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out into the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley. And lo, they were very dry. The word of the Lord goes on to say, and he said unto me, son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. And he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. The word goes on to say, thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking, and the bones came together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them. Then he said unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus said the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. So I prophesy as he commanded me. And the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. I would like to come from the topic, cough it up. Cough it up. Cough it up. What has the devil stolen from you? I mean, if you believe and act from God's word, you will go into what I like to say, supernatural recovery. And God will make the devil cough it up. See, I came with a message, and God is saying to announce the devil, he has to cough up your goods. See, over and over, the Bible makes it clear that once you believe, you must confess or speak that thing you believe. The word of the Lord goes on to also say that once you believe, you have to speak. 2 Corinthians 4:13 says it like this. It says, we all have the same spirit of faith. According to as it is written, I believe, have I spoken. We also believe, therefore speak. So we believe, therefore we speak. So what I'm trying to say, people of God, is that when you speak the word of God, it brings power, it brings God's power and authority to bear on your physical problem. See, that's why we have to continually rehearse the promises of God. And what I mean by rehearse, we have to speak. We have to speak it by faith and prepare for the manifestation. And what that does, when you speak it by faith, what it will do, it will begin to release an anointing of restitution. See, I might not be talking to everybody, amen, but I know I'm talking to somebody that has lost some stuff. Somebody who has lost some stuff and you want to get it back. And the time when so much is being taken away from us, what I'm getting ready to say may sound crazy,
But it looks like and feels like everything has been taken from us. You know, they want to take away our freedom of speech, amen. They want to take away our right to defend ourselves. They want to take away our privacy, you know. They're dictating what we can or should not eat, amen. They're also taking away our right to choose our own health care, amen. They're also even taking the right to choose our own physicians. But there's an assignment and a mandate in this house, amen, that if you continue to speak the word of the Lord, amen, restitution will come. Restitution. And what I mean by restitution, the devil has to cough up the goods. The devil has to cough. What I'm saying is, I'm speaking that you got to get it back. See, I don't care if it's the government, I don't care if it's the IRS, the DHS, or the devil himself. What has been stolen from you, God said restitution is coming your way. Oh, restitution is coming your way. See, there may be many different names, there may be different titles, but ultimately, it is the devil who is the thief. Oh, the Bible says in Proverbs 6, it says if the thief is found or caught, he has to restore sevenfold, amen, and bring back all the substance of your house. And it's not that what's been stolen from you, or how it's been stolen from you, I have come to speak restitution. See, restitution is coming to you. Okay. Restitution. It's this definition is an act of restoring or a condition of being restored. Restitution of something to its rightful owner. A legal action serving to cause restitution of a previous state. It means to get it back. And get it back with new life. Yeah. If there's one thing that the Bible is that it has a record of God restored. If we recall from the book of Genesis to Revelation, God has been restored. If there's any testament of God restoring, you just look at it. Ezekiel chapter 37. Now, if you look at this, something unique I saw. You see that God asked the prophet the question, can these bones live again? Okay. The prophet's answer shows us how bad the situation was. Okay? He answered, Lord God, thou knowest. So in other words, the prophet has to shift his attention from the problem to the power of God. If you need a miracle, if you need a deliverance, if you need healing, you need breakthrough, you have to shift your attention from the problem to the power of God. You have to take your eyes off the problem. You have to take your eyes off the problem and get into the power of God. See, when you look at the problem, amen, think about the problem, or even talk about the problem, it's going to do something to you, amen. It's going to frustrate you. It's going to make you feel uncomfortable, amen. See, Ezekiel knew that the situation was beyond his ability. He knew that the only one who could change it was God. See, every one of us will come to a place where we say, Lord God, thou knowest. Lord God, thou knowest with my finances. Lord God, thou knowest about my marriage. Lord God, thou knowest about my employment. We will come to that place where we have to say, Lord God, thou knowest. But it is the place where you know it is beyond human ability, where your mama can't do it, where your dad can't do it, where your doctor can't do it, where your lawyer can't do it. This is what you have to understand, because that's when you recognize that if this is going to happen, it's going to have the power of God in it.
Amen.
Ezekiel's answer was a statement of dependency.
Yes.
He recognized his insufficiency. Oh, man. And his weakness. And his need. But I love God's response. God says to him, prophesy upon these bones. It is though God saying, all I need from you was your dependence upon me. Now let's get to work. See, the valley of dry bones, I said, it represents the greatest grief. It represents the greatest misery, the greatest loss and destruction possible. It shows the very essence and totality of the word hopeless. It's the picture of the thief and his full destructive powers. See, that valley of dry bones it represented every area of human need and brokenness known to humanity. Every sickness, every disease, every oppression, every bondage, every financial struggle and disaster, every family strife, every family difficulty, it was represented there. But if you stop at verse 2, this is it. You will see nothing but hopelessness and despair if you just stop after verse 2.
Right.
But into that dreary valley of hopelessness, misery, and death, what came? The word of God.
Right.
Oh, man. It's amazing how one word of God can change everything.
Right.
Oh, man. See, hearing from God can change your entire posture of your life. Oh, man. God said to Ezekiel, he said, prophesy. The word of the Lord. Prophesy restitution. Prophesy restoration. Prophesy life. Prophesy new beginnings. Prophesy new life. And as he prophesied, what happened? The power of God came into the valley. And as he prophesied, the sinews and the flesh came upon these bones and the skin became the cover. And as he continued to prophesy, what happened? There was a noise and a shaking and the bones began to come together in perfect order. And to bone to his bone, but this is what it is. It's God restoring. You know, it's God putting back together. He's putting back together right. And then as he continued to prophesy, what happened? The wind of God, the ruach of God began to blow, amen. And then after that, what happened? That the breath of God began to fill into the lungs. And what happened? Strip, you know, they're broken to pieces, you know, you've been hung out and left to dry, you know, people who you thought was in your corner, ain't out in your corner, you know, you've been talked about, you've been laughed about, you've been lied about, amen, it seems like, oh, come on, y'all know who you are, y'all, the devil has stolen from you, the devil has robbed you, maybe it's physically, the devil has attacked your body, amen, attacked your finances, and your finances are dry, he's stolen your joy, amen, he's stolen your peace, amen, he's stolen your self-respect, he's stolen your dreams, and your hopes for the future, but God said to tell you, don't write it off, because it ain't over. He's getting ready to smoke the devil in your gut and make him cough up your goods. So how many of you are ready for the devil to cough up your goods? How many of you are ready to get back to restitution and your restoration? Somebody needs just to get mad at the devil and say, yeah, we got to cough up my goods, Lord. Amen. And to believe and to help you believe, encourage you just to keep moving the wind because favor will turn it around. You got to understand that your favor is an embarrassment to the enemy. I'm going to be encouraged to believe. Believe in your restitution. Believe in restitution in your finances, restitution in your health, restitution in your family, in your marriage. I'm declaring as we speak right now, divine reversal. Come on, y'all. Because somebody has been cheated out of your property. Somebody has been cheated by people you thought you were a friend. Somebody has been cheated by the government. Somebody has been cheated by the devil. But God said to tell you to get ready for a turnaround. Get ready for restitution. Get ready for redemption. Get ready for restoration. See, if there's anything you need to learn about the word of God, is that God is a God of turnaround. Amen. Restitution is coming.
Amen. Amen.
Praise God. But in order for restitution to come, you have to be in position. You have to be in position with your prayer life, your worship, your praise. David said it best. It's one of my favorite scriptures. He said, Lord, enlighten my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. David also said, Lord, I'm waiting for the Lord who bent down heard my cry, that drew me out and put a destruction out of the mud of the swamp and set my feet upon the rocks.
Yes.
See, it may look like and feel like that the devil has stolen and devoured everything that you had. But come on, people of God, let's remember what restitution means. Oh, man, come on. Restitution means a legal action serving the cause, restoration from one state or one condition. A legal action serving the cause, restoration to a previous state or condition. Okay. Legal action serving the cause, restoration from one state to a, from one previous state to another. Okay, so that's what I'm coming to tell you. There is a legal action taking place in the spirit. There you go. You gotta say. There's a legal action taking place in the spirit. So that's saying the thief has been caught, and the judge has ordered him to restore everything that he has stolen, and the devil is going to have to cough it up. Oh man, legal action is taking place in the spirit. Oh. John 20:15, what we just talked about, said, he has swallowed down riches. Here it is. And he shall cough them up again. God shall cast him out of the belly. Job lost everything he had. Job lost everything he had. And in a matter of hours, matter of minutes, he lost his flock. He lost his children. He lost his wealth. He lost his health. Friends, wife. It was just bad. Satan took everything he had. God allowed it, though. But Satan took everything he had. But in the end, God restored Job. God restored Job. And what did he do? He gave him double for his trouble. Okay. You need to think about that as, and God showed me in my study. It wasn't the fact that Joseph wasn't just an upright man. That wasn't the reason. It wasn't also the reason that he eschewed evil. Wasn't that. It wasn't also the fact that he feared God. It wasn't that, in reverence. But it's because of his position. Oh, man. Come on. If you read Job 1, the Bible specifically said, after what happened to him, when he lost everything, what did he do? The Bible says, he rented a mantle, he shaved his head, and he fell on the ground, and he worshiped. And what else the Bible says, Pastor? He didn't charge God foolishly, based off of everything that happened. He, oh man! He didn't charge God foolishly. So that's saying he worshiped through his tears. He worshiped through his groans. He worshiped with a broken heart. He worshiped through his pain. He worshiped through his confusion. Oh man, his worship kept him connected to his destiny. Oh man. And in the end, what happened? God blessed him. Says in the book of Psalms, it says, thou shalt arise and have mercy on the Zion, for the time to favor her, yet the set time is come. Yeah. That's the word right there. Amen. That's the word of the Lord. Speaking of restitution and restoration, I come here to encourage the body of Christ, my brothers, my sisters, my pastor, my first lady, my elders, my ministers, my deacons, my deaconess, people of God here. I come to tell you that it's a set time, that your favor, as I mentioned, is an embarrassment to the enemy. So the favor of God is on you, amen. This is your season of restoration. This is your season of restitution. So I know sometimes you may feel like God lost your number, or you forget that God may have forgotten about you, but I'm telling you, God tell you that God has the numbers of your head number, and he said, we can't leave that one forget about you. Okay. God remembered Hannah and gave her prophet Samuel. God remembered Noah, and he tried that the flood waters with the wind. Right. God remembered Abraham and delivered Lot on his account. God remembered Samuel. The word of the Lord says a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. My sheep hear my voice. I know that they follow me, and a stranger's voice that they will not follow. See, some of us have wondered why it's taking us so long. Why is your healing being delayed? Why is your miracle, your financial breakthrough is being delayed?
Yes.
I'm not the best philosopher, but I may have an idea. Maybe it's because God is working on your blessing, and he wants you to have the best. And the best takes time. Let me say that again. Let me say that again. I don't know if it's registered, but it's registered. Some of you may wonder why it's taking so long. Why is your healing being delayed? Why is your miracle being delayed? Why is your financial breakthrough being delayed? Well, maybe it's because God is working on your blessing. I just said that, so I know of the plans that I have for you. Plans of peace. And the Bible says, and not of evil. Okay. He knows I'm on his mind. He has plans for me. Okay. So maybe it's because God is working on your blessing, and he wants to give you the best, and the best takes time. See, God promised many of us, God's promised you Boaz, but a lot of us got impatient and wound up with Bozo. I said earlier that when you speak it by faith, you have to prepare. When you speak it, you believe. You have to prepare for the manifestation. So not just because of the timing and the best takes time, God has promised, Moses, but I'm also speaking that maybe God's perfect blessing, it's taking time, but God's perfect blessing in God's time versus our impatience and willingness to trust God. Okay. Also believe God is working on us because he wants to prepare us for what's about to happen, because he wants us to be able to handle and appreciate the blessings that's about to come. I don't care how bad it looks, or how bad it feels, or how bad it sounds. God's time is not our time. If you recall in 1 Samuel chapter 30, David was dismissed from the Philistines, and he didn't go to the camp of Israel, but he went to Ziklag. And if you recall in 1 Samuel chapter 30, when him and his men returned to Ziklag to find their city burnt with fire, and their wives and their children got taken as captives. So look at this. In the natural, everything they loved was gone. Destroyed. And this is something here. It got so bad that they sat down and wept. And the same men that was with David decided to stone him. But in essence of all that, what did David do? He encouraged himself. In the Lord. He called for the ephod, which is a priestly garment. And he began to worship the Lord in spite of what was around him.
That's right.
Oh, man.
That's true.
We're still talking about posture. See his posture? The people who he walked with his family, his city was burnt. And and the same people who he walked with wanted to stone him. But in the midst of that, David got his praise on Ziklag. See, in the place of desolation, the place of hopelessness, the place of misery, and the place of death, David praised the Lord. If you gotta read this, this is powerful. 1 Samuel 30. After all that, David said, he asked God a question. He said, shall I pursue? He conversed with the Lord in spite of what he was dealing with. He didn't do anything foolish. He didn't try to commit suicide. In depression, but the first thing he did, he went to God, and he went to God, and he asked God, shall I pursue?
That's right.
God said to him, you shall.
Don't get it.
He said, you shall pursue. And then he says, and you shall overtake. Another promise. Here we go. He was just talking about the Lord is not slack against his promises. He first said, you shall pursue. You shall overtake. And here's the killer right here. He said, you shall recover all. He told him, you shall pursue. You shall overtake. And you shall cover all. Meaning, he's on an assignment. David could have gone into deep depression. He could have committed suicide. He could have been killed by his own men. But he either did wrap himself in his self-pity, but David went into a praise. He got his praise on his Ziklag. And when David went into a praise, David also went into a recovery. Amen. You may be in the darkest hour of your life. Amen. It may look impossible. It may look hard. It may look difficult. It may look out of the ordinary. But God sent me here to speak restitution to you. God sent me here to speak restoration to you. God sent me here to speak life to you. God sent me here to speak new beginnings to you. God sent me here to speak redemption to you. God sent me here on an assignment to speak life into a situation that may look bad. But if you allow yourself to be in a certain posture, if you allow yourself to be connected to the source, God will give you restitution. So I'm here to tell you that the same God that spoke to David, the same God that spoke to Job, the same God is still speaking to you. And you got to understand that in this season, yes, trials will come. Yes, it will be difficult. But you shall pursue. You shall overtake them. You shall recover all. You may see nothing but ashes, amen. But if you will follow David's example and begin to encourage yourself in the Lord and get your praise on and get your worship on, God will fight for you. Amen. God will hold you up when you need to be held up. God will cause the devil to turn loose of everything that belongs to you. Oh, okay. God will have you to release that joy off of my child. Across my town, okay. You're welcome. Pump it up, yo. Pump it up.
Yes, God. You may not know it, but your praise is your prophecy. Uproot you from your foundation. As I mentioned, Job lost everything. But God restored him. His position caught the eye of God. His wife told him to curse God if God. But Job still did not give it. He thanked God for it. We thank God. I personally, amen. Because we know that the Bible says we overcome our testimonies. And I'm sure as all of you in this house sound my voice, I've been going through, I'm going to tell you, the worst 4 months of my life. And I'm going to be real with y'all. I thank God for my pastor. I'm going to tell you why. I thank God for him because even in my disobedience, he still loved me. He still did not allow my mentality to change his perception of me. Don't miss that. He didn't allow what he see change his perception of me. And I honor God for him. I honor God for him. The Bible says love is patient. When you have true love, when you have true love, your patience will continue to prosper. And as it did with this man of God, I honor God for him. Because he didn't have to give me this opportunity, but he saw something. He saw something in me that maybe some other may not have seen. But I thank God for him. But my encouragement to you is that help is on the way. God did not bring you this far to leave. Many of us are going through storms, you know, the situation. You know, the transition is not easy. The Bible says many are called, but few are chosen. But even when I said in that scripture earlier, I said, consider it not strange to the fiery trials to try you as though something strange has happened. But the Bible also says after that, but rejoice as ye are partakers of Christ's suffering. Oh. In this world ye shall have tribulation. But don't fret, for I have overcome the world. See what I'm doing? I'm rehearsing the promises of God. We had an awesome in the word class this past Thursday, and Pastor talked about when Jesus was tempted. The Bible said in Matthew 4, the Spirit drove him to the wilderness. The Spirit drove him. When he was driven to the wilderness, the devil came. And it's funny how the devil will come at you at your weakest point to try to do everything he can to deter you from your connection with power source. But he said something unique.
Every time that the enemy tried to come at Jesus, Jesus came back with the word. Heaven and earth shall pass, but his word shall stand. He came back with the word. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. God is not slack against his promises. And like I said earlier, maybe God, you might not have everything that you want right now, but God is giving you everything that you need. He wants the best for you. Jeremiah 29:11, he wants the best for you. And he wants to give you the best. And he's sovereign. He's sovereign. One of the fruits of the Spirit is long suffering. Love, joy, peace. Long suffering. We don't want to do long suffering. Love, okay. Faith. Joy, oh yeah. Joy, peace. Long suffering. We don't want long suffering. We call it the suffering. But I thank God for restitution. I thank God for the legal action that's causing restoration to a previous state. I won't always be like this. I'm on 121 days. I'm counting the days. As I said, last time I was behind this pulpit, I preached, give God an ugly praise. And what I meant by that, you know, like I said, Job went through so much. He got ugly with it. He shaved his head, went into tears, groans, but it caught God's attention because it was sincere. So what I'm saying is that it won't always be like this. But it's going to take time. And when God blesses you, he's going to bless you in the right way. And you're going to use that same testimony, that same test, and use that testimony to bring somebody else out. Paul and Silas was in the midnight praise. And when they was in the midnight praise, even though they were shackled, even though they was held down, but they caught the attention of God because of their posture, and then an angel came down and came, took them out. And when they got taken out, they saw a soldier there, and the soldier was in amazement at what happened. And Paul said, I came just for you, because that soldier gave his life to the Lord. You go through to bring someone else out. If you can, just lift your hands. God, we thank you for what has transpired. We thank you, Lord, for your word. We thank you, Lord, for restitution. We thank you, Lord, for restoration. So, Father, at the sound of my voice, I'm praying right now for my fellow brothers and sisters right now, Father. I'm praying right now that you just continue to meet them at their needs. Father, we ask and thank you, Lord. We praise you right now, Lord, for what has transpired. We thank you, Lord, for the legal action that is taking place in the spirit right now. So, Father, we just pray right now, Father, that we have that same praise, that we have that same worship, that we have that same prayer, Father. We know, Father, that all things work together for the good. So, Father, I touch and agree right now. I declare restoration. I declare restitution. Hey, Father, I even declare a new anointing level right now, Father. So, Father, we thank you for what you are doing right now, Father. Yes, it may be hard, but, Father, you said in your word that you will never leave and you will never will forsake. So, Father, continue to order our steps, Father, and all that we say, and all that we do, Father, that it may be for your glory, Father. So, Father, I just thank you right now. I lift up my pastor right now, Father. I lift up my first lady right now. I ask that you just continue to strengthen them. Continue, Father, to pour into them, Father, as they pour it onto your sheep, Father. I just thank you, Lord, for what you're doing in their life. So, Father, I pray for a hedge of protection. I pray, Father, that you just continue to cover them, continue to anoint them for such a time as this, Father. Father, as I mentioned earlier, Father, we all have the same faith, Father. We are one body. So, Father, I pray right now that you just continue to strengthen our eyes. Father, do not allow what we see to hinder the God that you are. So, Father, I pray right now that you erase the fog of reality, but allow us to and restoration is coming, Father. We thank you for your promises, Father. Your promises are yes and amen. So, Father, we say it to be so in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' name, let us all say amen.
This is the air I breathe.
This is the air I breathe.
This is the air I breathe.
This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence, your holy presence. Your
and
God show you? The Bible said when David got there, their children was there, their wives was there, and he said, don't leave without taking the extra spoils. In other words, when you obey God, he's going to give you an abundance of more than what you have. Come on, lift your voice saying, God is a perfecter of what he does. God perfects what he does. We have to stop faulting God for what he perfected. And say, God, where you need me to be at in this situation? He's just testing your faith. And you said, God, I want to go after you. God said, I ain't tell you to go yet because you don't trust me yet. Within their spirit, they made a conscious decision that I'm going to trust you. Though the enemy may slay me, yeah, but I'll trust you. I don't understand why I went through this. I don't understand why I lost my loved one. I don't understand why you did this. But one thing I do know. That God, you're on my side. Yes. And God is on your side. Yes. After I thank you, you shall recover. No more complaining. Stop fighting. Stop complaining. And say, God, I surrender everything to you. I'm tired. I'm angry. I'm frustrated. And God said, this is right where I want you to be, to see my face, so that I can show you how you can go get everything that the enemy tried to take from you. Go back and get with the power of the Lord, everything that the enemy tried. God said, it's waiting right around the corner. I'm just waiting for you to trust me and take me at my word. I'm telling you, today, my brothers and sisters, it's right for the taking. It's right for the taking. Stay with God. I'm telling you, hallelujah. Stay with God from your heart. He knows your heart. He knows what you're dealing with. And I'm telling you, you stay with God and watch what God does. God's delay is not his denial. His delay is to make sure that when he gives it to you, I'm telling you, it's a new day. Yeah.
If we do what God said, if we do, gifts are just possibility. You may or may not, but I believe in you will. If you do what God said, the enemy has to cough back everything that he tried to do to mess you up. It ain't over. God will give you back. I'm a living witness. I'm a living witness. He'll do it. He's just testing you. And in the midst of your test, the enemy's going to tempt you. But he got me before, but he won't get me again. You have to speak life. You have to speak life. Come on, touch yourself. Repeat after me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I stand before you, surrendering my thoughts, surrendering my ways. I hand them over to you. You are the head. You are the Lord. You are my Alpha. You are my Omega. So God, I surrender in the name of Jesus. I will speak life in the name of Jesus. I will speak life in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Come on, give God some glory.
Shall betray me. And so the man goeth, even as it is written of him. But woe unto that man through whom the Son of Man is betrayed. Good were it for that man if he had not been born. And Judas, who betrayed him, answered and said, Is it I, Rabbi? He said unto him, Thou hast said. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread, and blessed, and brake it. And he gave it to the disciples, and said, Take, eat, this is my body. And he took a cup, and gave thanks, and gave to them, saying, Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many unto remission of sins. But I say unto you, I shall not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine, until that day when I drink it new, with you in my Father's kingdom. Amen.
Amen. Ask me for forgiveness that you may be able to be a worthy partaker and take this supper with me. It says some have eaten and drinking this unworthy, and the Bible said that they have fallen asleep, which means simply they died. Amen. But what God said, because when they took it, they did not ask God for forgiveness before, and then when they got up, they went and did whatever they wanted to do. Amen. But if you don't take this, he said you have no part with me.
Amen.
Amen. So let a man and woman examine themselves. Amen. So let us pray that we may be worthy partakers of the Lord's Supper on today. Amen. Father, we thank you and we celebrate you for this time. We pray now that you would change this bread, which represents your body, from its common use to a spiritual. We ask that you would change this wine, which represents your blood, from its common use to a spiritual. And then while we sit here individually, we ask you, God, to forgive us for anything that we may have done that may have not been worthy to partake of this. But God, you said if we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So Father, we thank you, God, that because of what Jesus did on the cross, for our past sin, our present sin, and future sin, that it was remitted on the cross. And for the remission of sins, God, we can sit before you on today, and that we may be a worthy partaker. And thank you for justifying us, that we may be able to sit at the table with you on today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Afterwards, he took the bread, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples. After that, he took the cup and he poured it and he gave it to his disciples. My brothers and my sisters, we want to prepare ourselves. We ask you to follow the direction of the ushers as we come and commune on today. Amen.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Father,
Hallelujah.
Changes to the high.
Oh,
pray that you had an awesome experience. We thank God for our friends that have shown up or visitors. We pray you can come and shake my hand. First lady will be here for a moment. I'm praying, hey God, whoever can go with us, please, y'all know my bishop, man. He would love to see us. You know how he is. We're going to leave here approximately at 3 o'clock. Matter of fact, for y'all's sake, 2:50.
Amen.
2:50, we want to be in the cars and on the highway. Amen. We do have some room if you want to go on this transportation. You come on and go with us, and let's celebrate that anniversary. Amen. Also, keep Minister Donald in your prayers. Let me tell you something. Anytime you preach hard like that, the enemy's going to attack you. That's what you do. They'll come with your throat, they'll come with your head, your side. That's what it is. Because, listen, remember Paul talking, we ain't going to stay here, but Paul said, you know, I was soaking on 3 times. Why me? I ain't going up there preaching until I'm going to feel goodness, you know? And that thorn sometimes reminds us it ain't us. It's him. Amen. So sometimes God has to remind us, when you're going to get done preaching, keep yourself, not that he's doing that, but keep yourself. If it ain't for me, you can't do nothing. And sometimes he got to hit us with some stuff, you know? So that's probably why you get hit with some stuff, just a reminder to keep you in check. Amen. In the time of your weakness, he'll become your strength. He tells Paul, my grace, my favor is sufficient for whatever you're dealing with. My favor, I do it. Amen. Amen. So we thank God for all that thing. And Father, we thank you as we prepare ourselves. As we go for the third watch of the day, we pray, God, that you will send the word with power, with clarity. We pray that we will have an awesome time in your move. And God, we thank you for the move that we had here on today. From power hour to power pack, to worship, to praise, to everything. We thank you. So, Father, let us meditate on your goodness. Communion, we thank you right now. Father, but as we leave this place forever, your presence, give us traveling mercy as we travel the highways and byways. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Let all God's people say amen. 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 Shake somebody's hand, give them a hug, let them know you love them, and Jesus loves them too. Amen. Remember, 2:50, come on. Those of you going, I hate to say, I ain't going. Yes, you are. You're going. I'm prophesying. You should speak in them bones. Bunch of dry bones. Thank you.